book on women leadership, and I have dedicated to three women heroines. One is Rosa Parks, second Maya Angelou, third Oprah Winfrey.
Okay. And tell me a little bit about your admiration for all three of those women. What is it about Rosa Parks and Maya Angelou that you really admire, as well as that leader of yours in India? So I'd love to hear a little bit about your admiration for these women and what it is about their leadership qualities that you admire.
Rosa Parks, I admire because she stood up for, she was denied a seat in the bus. That's what I read.
Right.
She stood up her ground. Okay. That was the one thing that changed, that brought a revolution, okay, across the world, one. Second thing, Maya Angelou underwent lots of sufferings. Even my life is also like Maya Angelou. I was born in a toxic family, grew up in a toxic environment. At the age of 18, I joined the Indian Air Force to support my parents. And I am still struggling with so many financial challenges, but I am passionate about sharing my knowledge freely with the world. I am passionate about building a better world because I have one life. Within one life, whatever the best possible, I want to do it, right? So I admire Maya Angelou because of her struggles and suffering. She overcame all the struggles and sufferings, and she became a legend. Now, I also admire Oprah Winfrey because she's a media tycoon. She also encountered lots of challenges, but she overcame all the challenges, and she's an inspiration for many people, especially for the women across the world. Because of these reasons, although these three are from a different country, I dedicated my book to them. See, leader is a leader. Irrespective of the country, irrespective of the gender, irrespective of the culture, irrespective of the caste, irrespective of the religion. Okay, I admire leaders. Leaders are leaders. Abraham Lincoln is an American. I admire because he is one of the best leaders in the world, according to me. So likewise.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely agree with you on that. Now, do you think that it sometimes takes great turmoil and great suffering in order to have great leadership? Because I know that whenever we hear about great leaders, whether it was Malcolm X, whether it was Martin Luther King, whether it was Nelson Mandela, a lot of times they did go kind of like what you went through. They went through different kinds of suffering in order to build up their leadership qualities. So do you think that you need to have those kind of like turmoils and pains in your life in order to be a great leader, or can you succeed without having those kind of conflicts in life?
No. It's a great question. It is. You have touched my heart, really. Wonderful question you have asked. I admire Martin Luther King because he fought the equality of blacks along with whites.
Right.
And he was assassinated. He lived for principles, right? And I admire South African leader Nelson Mandela.
Right.
27 years he was jailed. Okay. So when you look at these people, the sufferings make them very tough.
Right.